Hey y'all, Grand Rising. So me being an earth sign, I don't know, I just love being in nature. I love, you know, being outside. So I don't know, I decided to take my talents outside today. So I'm gonna ask for the collective, what do y'all guys need to receive? You know, what do you need to focus on this week? And what do you need to surrender, okay? So let's get it. Spirit Squad, the universe, and the Most High. What does the collective need to receive? What do they need to receive? What do we need to do this week? What's going on? What we need to focus on? Emerge. Bottom of the deck, we got practice. Rest at the bottom of the deck. All right, we pull the cards out and then we figure it out from there. See what spirit's trying to tell me. But I already see so far what's going on. Whoa, what fell out? So we have going forward, potential, and protection. Fire Guardian. La Bruja. La Bruja. Ending. Then we got death. We got trust here too. It's getting my attention. Let's see what else. What do they need to focus on? What do they need to focus on? Windfall. Changes. Yeah, the end of an arrow. Let me turn this music off a little bit. Alright, so emerge, practice, listen quietly, plant a seed and wait, and rest. So right off the bat, they're telling me, you know, like, it's time to get it popping. There's something that you want to do that you're trying to, you know, put some practice into it, or you're trying to make it come into fruition with the, you know, plant a seed and wait. So spirit is telling you, you know, plant the seed, practice as much as you can, do what you got to do to make this you know, this craft or whatever it is that you're trying to bring about. They're telling you, you know, just put the work into it. We have this as the last card, rest. So this could be telling me that either you already been resting, you know, spirit is trying to tell you is enough time, you know, you've been resting enough, it's time to get it popping now. Because I do have here going forward, and we have potential. So, you know, spirit is telling you, you know, you have potential to do whatever it is that you're trying to do. And you are going to be able to, you know, move forward with this plan, you know, and they're telling you that you are protected. So, you know, your spirit squad is holding you down. They're making sure that, you know, you're going to be able to do whatever it is that you're trying to do. But you got to put the footwork into it. So, the footwork is putting practice into it. We have here, listen quietly. So, that could mean, you know, tapping in with your spirit guides, you know. Doing some meditation to see what guidance you need to receive. But if not, you know, you're getting it from me. And what else? And emerge. Yeah, so I feel like it's time. So now, what's getting my attention is the Death card and the End of an Era. So it says here, I am learning that endings are merely beginnings, okay? So this is connecting with this as well, you know, like, it's time now to start this new beginning, you know? Whatever happened in the past, if you was resting, you know, taking your time in the past, that's fine. But now it's time to get it popping, you know? So that's what I'm getting with this. We have here body changes. I feel like body changes is definitely connecting to the rest. So again, if you already did, you know, the resting, it's time to get it popping. If you haven't rest and you've been, you know, putting in a lot of work into this project or into whatever it is that you're trying to do, spirit is saying now just wait. You know, you already planted the seed, you already practiced, you already been tapping in with spirit, you good. All you need to do now is just rest and wait for it to, you know, to pop off, okay? But if you haven't, then spirit is telling you, you know, with the body changes, take a break, okay? So now, take a break and just, you know, and wait for it to pop off, okay? So now we have here windfall. I feel like they're letting you know that whatever it is that is, I'm sorry, there's a lot of background noise. Whatever it is that you're trying to do, you're going to get a windfall, you know, of abundance, okay? Finances, good luck, you know, whatever it is that you're trying to do is going to work for you. So we have the Fire Guardian. They're telling you to ignite your passion. So right off the bat, it's the same message connecting with this. You know, it's time. It's time to emerge. It's time to get it popping. That's what ignite your passion is. You know, put the battery on your back. That's basically what they're saying with that. So now we have here trust. I feel like they're telling you with this, I accept that my inner voice will always guide me correctly. That's exactly what we got here. Listen quietly, you know, your inner voice, your intuition, your spirit guides is trying to guide you. So tap in. Now, with the Envy card, this is letting you know, don't look at whatever everybody else is doing, you know, don't be thinking like, oh, you know, I want to do that too, and you know, this person is getting more views than me, or this person is getting more people than me, and you know, no, everybody got their own lane. Everything is divinely guided for everybody. Look how many tarot readers we got now, you know, look how many bread companies we got, you know, there's a lot of different, you know, options, and if it is something that you're getting into that has to do with tarot or anything spiritual, let me tell you something. From somebody who just got into the game, you know, I see that there is a lot of competition, but I also realize that your spirit guide is gonna guide whoever's supposed to come to you. So there is no competition. We all out here to try to help others. We all out here to give the messages from spirits, you know, to the people that cannot tap in. So we're all, you know, we all have the same goal here to help humanity, you know, to do what we gotta do. Oh shit, that's not good. I did not plan that. All right, spirit. All right, maybe that's what they're trying to say, like, yeah. All right, but I got that. So basically, you know, that's what I'm saying with this card. Like, don't look at what everybody else is doing. Just focus on you, because whatever it is that you're going to do, that's on your soul purpose, you know? Like, that's something that you was here to do, so just do it. You know, if it's your passion, because we do have a card that talks about your passion igniting. So if it is something that you're going to do is, like, your passion, you know, you're going to be good no matter what. When you follow your passion, you're going to be straight no matter what, because that's something that you're supposed to do. That's something that you came here to do, okay? So don't look at what anybody else is doing. Don't compare yourself. Just stay on your lane, focus on what you got to do, and you straight, all right? It says, I am the same as everybody, but with different challenges, you know? Everybody got different challenges. Everybody got different, you know, obstacles and shit like that. You know, some get there faster than the other, but you don't have to worry about none of that, because, like I said, everything is divinely guided, okay? And as a matter of fact, we already got that with the card here, protection. You protected. You being divinely guided, okay? Everything that's happening right now is happening exactly how it's supposed to, you know? Don't try to rush it. Don't try to compare yourself to nobody else. None of that, all right? Focus on you and what you're doing, because it's going to work out for you, okay? So let's see what you got to surrender or surrender to this week. Yo, surrender to rest and sleep. Bottom of the deck, we have surrender denial and surrender fears. So, surrender to rest and sleep. Loud and clear, spirit been telling you to rest. I don't even know where it is, but I think it blew away with the wind. I'm gonna go get it later. But anyways, surrender to rest and sleep. Spirit been saying that. It said it with the card, you know, to rest. And I was saying, I don't know if you already rested or not, you know, but it says here to prevent a burnout, slow down, honor your need for quiet time and peaceful sleep to rejuvenate your mind, body, and spirit. And quiet time is also connecting to the listening to your inner voice, you know. That's also connecting with you know, meditation, you know, and tapping in with your spirit guides. So to prevent a burnout. So maybe you've been going really hard, you know, and that's basically what Spirit was saying. Like, you know, you already did everything. You did the practice, you already you know, perfected your craft, and you already, you know, put the seed in. So now all you have to do now is just wait, you know? Rejuvenate yourself right now. So we have surrender denial, accept people and situations exactly as they are without denying the difficulties. Then you can see things clearly and make the best decisions. Maybe you are in denial thinking that you're not going to be able to do this. You know, you're probably thinking like, oh, you know, I'm not going to be able to do this. You know? Spirit is telling you, release that, you know. Accept the situation exactly as it is, you know, like with the empty card, you know. Everything is happening exactly how it's supposed to be, okay? Don't stress anything about how it's working out or whatever. It's going to work out. And we have surrender fear. Let go of the fearful stories that you are telling yourself. Stay in the moment. Focus on solutions and celebrate every baby step forward. That's connecting with denial. You know, like if you have a fear, you know, you're thinking it's not going to work out. You're thinking there's too many people in the same field, you know. Don't think like that. You got your own lane, your own divinely guided lane. I'm going to pull this one again. Like, this is the Spirit telling you, we got you. We pushing you through on your lane. You don't have to worry about nobody else. What else? The collective needs to receive right now. What do they need to receive? Someone is being cautious and wearing a protective barrier. Get one more. Divine timing. We have here confusion and enlightenment. So what I'm feeling like right here, because this is a love deck, but it gives you the message anyway. Right now, you know, you're being cautious, you know, you thinking, you know, I don't know if I should make this move or whatever, and here goes the wind again. I was not ready for none of this, I swear. I just freezed down. I was like, you know, I'm going to go outside. Let me put these crystals on here so they don't fly away anymore. So anyways, with these cards, basically Spirit is saying right now, you know, you're very cautious. You don't know if you should move forward with this or not, right? You're thinking because we have confusion, you know, you're not clear. You know, there's an uncertainty here about what's gonna, you know, pop off. You're thinking, you know, is this gonna really work for me, blah blah blah, right? So then we have here enlightenment and divine timing. So with these cards, Spirit is telling you, you know, you are going to get enlightened, you know, into as to what it is that you need to do. And I feel like through this reading, you're getting the clarity that Spirit is telling you very loud and clear. Go for it. Push forward. And then divine timing, they're telling you, you know, this connection is divinely guided and supported. But, you know, like I said, it's not a love reading. So they're telling you that you are divinely guided and supported. And also know that everything is happening on divine timing, which is going back to the envy card. You know, if you're wondering why this person is doing, you know, a little better than me or, you know, stuff like that. Everything is happening exactly how it's supposed to happen. You have nothing to worry about. Just go with the flow and know that your spirit guides got your back. Pull one more. Oh, let's pull the money deck. What does the collective need to receive for this week? What do they need to receive when it comes to your finances and career? What do they need to receive? Media. Step into the spotlight and get seen. Don't allow your talent to go unnoticed. A career in television, radio, magazine, or any mass media job might be perfect for you. It might be time to just get more publicity if you want to increase your finances. So yeah, I'm getting goosebumps right now. I don't know if y'all can see that, but that's confirmation. Spirit is telling you, you know, again, whatever it is that you're trying to do, I feel like it could be something, you know, like what's popping off right now. Like a lot of people doing YouTube, a lot of people, you know, they're getting into that because it's the time right now, the era of the Aquarius, you know, and that's my rising sign. So, you know, this is like what I'm doing now, like this is the time for us to be doing this, you know, to get on social media, to get on YouTube, to do the tarot. Like this is our time, y'all. So if this is somebody who's, you know, into this, do it, okay? Do it. You know, step into the spotlight and get seen. Don't allow your talent to go unnoticed. Exactly, you know, get out there. Like they said, follow your passion. You're being guided to do this, okay? Now, it could be television, radio, or, you know, maybe a podcast, YouTube, you know, that type of stuff. They're telling you, you know, just go for it. Bottom of the deck, we have options. So they're letting you know you have a lot of opportunities coming your way. It says many opportunities are becoming available to you now. Or maybe you flooded by too many ideas. Do not get stuck in doubt when an offer presents itself. Seize the moment. And it says to create multiple streams of income. That's the time that we are right now. We're not on no traditional shit no more. We are here to, you know, do things like an entrepreneur. You know, to have many options. You know, don't just get your income from one stream. You know, get it from different places. So I feel like definitely spirit is telling you to push forward. Do it. What I just said, bro. What I just said. It's the time for us entrepreneurs. It says you are either about to take your finances to the next level, or it's time that you do. If your finances have not improved yet, you can be certain that it will soon. And then it says there's a chance of something extra in the air. Be a boss. It's time for you to boss up, all right? You got this. So I hope I was able to give you the clarity you was looking for. Give me some, you know, some feedback. Let me get a like, a comment, whatever it is. Let me know that you got the message loud and clear, all right? Take care, guys.